Good morning and welcome to our Wednesday morning devotional brought to you by First United Methodist in Mount Gilead. If you're looking for a church home or you don't have one, we invite you to come worship with us. Sunday morning worship service at 11, Sunday school 9:45. And if you are an early bird, we welcome you to our sister church, Zion United Methodist, located in the PD community. If you will, let's all bow for a short prayer. Our Father and God, we give you thanks for this time together, that we come to you in word and in story. Father, we just ask that you will open our hearts that we may have a little better understanding of what our scripture is trying to tell us. Father, we thank you for this coming Thanksgiving season and just pray that you will open our hearts that we can not only be thankful, but that we can share our bounty with others. All this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. I have two scriptures this morning. One is from Psalms 100. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. And one verse from Philippians 4, verse 6. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer, by petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. Well, next week we'll be getting ready for the Thanksgiving holiday. Now, a day or several days before this holiday, the cooks will be preparing a banquet-style feast shared with family and friends. And on that Thanksgiving Thursday, many of us will be sitting around the table, enjoying a meal that has been prepared for us of turkey and ham, homemade cornbread dressing with Gilbert gravy, green beans, mac and cheese, sweet potatoes, collards, pumpkin pie, and delicious cake. Well, folks, I'm ready to eat now, but I guess we'll have to wait a few more days. A day that we try not to count our calories, but enjoy the good food that is before us. But not everyone will have this banquet to enjoy. As our country slowly emerges from 20 months of COVID restrictions, some families face the realities of lost or sick family members and friends. Some will face the reality of strained finances. Some will be missing family that are serving in the military or maybe living away from home and not able to enjoy the family time together. Whatever your circumstances this season, do not doubt God's goodness towards you. Sometimes he allows us to go through difficulties, but he does not leave you alone in them, and promises, his promises never fail. As a passage above states, he is good and he will bring you through. At times I am overwhelmed that we serve an all-powerful God whose goodness overflows into our lives every day. Even in the midst of trials, God is seeking our good to teach us something and draw us closer to him. This Thanksgiving, in the midst of turkey and pie and football and parties, don't forget to take some time treasuring God's goodness to you. Thank him and praise him, and let those delivered by the Lord speak out. Notice the Bible does not command you to feel thankful in all circumstances. Instead, it commands you to give thanks in all circumstances. When I begin to praise God in a difficult situation, even if I don't feel like it, many times the scales fall from my eyes, and I begin to see glimpses of his glory sprinkled on the black backdrop of situations like diamonds on black velvet. Sometimes I don't see glory in tragedy, but I can still praise God because I know he is there. The scriptures tell us that God will never leave us or forsake us. We are never alone. Praise God. Gratitude changes the lenses through which we see the circumstances in our little slice of time. Thanksgiving changes our perspective despite broken dreams, broken relationships and circumstances, and unfulfilled longings. So as we prepare our hearts for this Thanksgiving, what are you truly thankful for? Family, friends, food, health, or healing, good weather, good neighbors, maybe a good church, and a God that loves even me. Thanksgiving should be celebrated every day of the year in all circumstances. And I'd like to close by reading Philippians 4, verse 6 again. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer, petition, and with thanksgiving, present your request to God. Let us bow for a closing prayer. Our Father and our God, as we prepare for this Thanksgiving season, Father, we thank you for the bounty of life that we enjoy. Father, we thank you for our good times, and yes, we thank you for being with us in the times that are not so good. Father, we pray for our family and friends as they may travel to be together. And Father, we thank you for all those that have prepared the banquet that we are about to enjoy. All this, Father, we ask in Jesus, your Son and our Savior. Amen. Folks, we hope you have a blessed day and hope to see you next Thursday or next Wednesday. Thank you.